okay, Lord. And I asked God to help me to elaborate on this. And so what I wanted to title this message is, There Is a Sound.
My Lord.
There is a sound.
All right.
And the reason why is because as you read in Titus 1:9, it says, holding fast the faithful word as he has been taught, that he may be able by sound doctrine, both to exhort and convict those who contradict.
Yes.
And then in verse 7, it said, in all things, chapter 2, verse 7 and 8 in Titus, in all things showing yourself to be a pattern of good works, in doctrine, showing integrity, reverence, and corruptibility, sound speech,
yes,
that cannot be condemned, that one whose opponent may be ashamed, not having anything evil to say of you. And then in 13, Titus chapter 1, it says, this testimony is true. Therefore, rebuke them sharply that they may be sound in the faith.
My Lord, my Lord.
So there's three particular sounds that God is speaking of.
Revelate.
There is a sound. We have sound doctrine.
Uh-huh.
We have sound faith.
Teach.
We have sound speech.
My God.
So again, God is calling us to hear his voice through his word.
My
we
Lord.
We have to be listening. The world, we know, we always talk about how the world is so distracted by so many,
yes,
so many different sounds.
Yes, they are.
We have sounds of divisions and sounds of hatred and, yes, sounds,
Jesus,
of just envy and gossip, whatever the sound may be. It could, yes, even just be the sounds of just birds chirping, whatever the case, sounds, yes, of social media.
Yes, yes.
Sounds, yes, of TV, sounds of people mocking, or just whatever the case. We hear, yes, so many things.
Yes, my Lord.
But God is saying there is a specific sound that
we need to listen to.
That's it. We have to open up our spiritual ears.
Come on, woman of God.
To God's sound.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
We have to be focused and positioned, because you know how when, I know Pastor, she was talking about how she heard the sound of the alarm. Yes. That was an easy sound to hear, because it blew the eardrums out of people's ears.
Yes.
But sometimes you got to refocus your thinking.
Yes.
And hear specific sounds. Like,
hallelujah.
Outside, you got to turn down the TV distinguish what's going on, and you got to focus in.
And hear
so that we can hear.
Yes,
the
Lord.
That's what God is telling us. We got to get focused so that we,
Jesus,
can hear the sound.
Yes.
There is a sound. Amen.
Thank, yes, you, Jesus.
So Paul, he was writing this letter about some specific sounds we must give attention to.
Jesus.
As I said before, there's sound doctrine,
sound
faith, and sound speech.
My Lord.
You know, I used to tell Pastor all the time, you know, God, I'm just not hearing God, Pastor. I'm just not hearing him. I'm not hearing him. I'm not hearing him. But the Lord began to tell me, it's because you're not listening. See, what I was expecting, and Pastor, we always say that we are expecting it to, Lord, I need a word, I need a word. We expect it to always come through people.
Yes.
And God's word is his voice.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
That's why it is sound doctrine.
Yes.
It's true, it's unwavering, it doesn't change. So
amen now.
It may not always come through a prophetic man, yes, or woman of God,
that's,
but
right,
it's right here in the word.
Thank you,
of God.
Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Well, so we have to listen to that sound.
Glory,
Jesus,
be to God.
Says, he knows the sheep know my voice, and the stranger,
they will
not follow.
Hallelujah.
So we know that God's word is God's voice.
Yes.
If we follow this, the sound doctrine, we will not be easily entangled to follow something else or follow a different sound that is not of God.
Jesus.
Here,
Jesus.
In Revelation chapter 3 and in chapter 2, it says that he said three times, the Spirit of the Lord said, he who has an ear, let him hear.
Yes, Lord.
It says to the churches.
Yes.
So in three times, as the John had wrote the book of Revelation, God came to him and said, he who has an ear, let him hear.
Mm-hmm.
So this is it's imperative that we are listening, people of God.
Yes.
We are hearing the sound of God. There
Thank
is a
you,
sound.
Jesus.
Amen.
Yes. There is a sound.
Himself, he said in Mark chapter 4:9, he said, he who has an ear, let him hear.
My Lord.
So we have to listen to the specific sounds of God.
Jesus.
But the only way to interpret these sounds are through his word. Amen.
My Lord.
Yes.
So let's Thank you, Lord.
Sounds.
Thank
I'll
you, Lord.
We share these three particular sounds based on the word of God.
Yes.
So sound doctrine, we're going to talk about that first. It's defined as healthy, uncorrupted, and true, and it's unchanged.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Sound doctrine does not change.
All right.
Sound doctrine is not
Say that. Say
it's
that.
Not wavering.
All right.
Jesus is not saying anything different.
Come on now.
All right. There is no new thing under the sun.
My Lord.
Sound doctrine does not change for the times.
Will you say that?
People talk change. It doesn't change because media and social.
Come on now. Come on now.
This is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
One thing that we have to get back to and realize what truly sound doctrine is. First of all, sound doctrine is the characteristics of God.
Yes.
Everything that you want to know about our Father is in His Word.
Yes, it is.
Everything we want to know about Jesus Christ is in the Word.
Thank you, Father.
Sound.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Forever.
Sound doctrine was established by God's Word.
Yes.
God established the earth because of sound doctrine.
Well,
as you can see, that tree in the outside, it doesn't move. It sits there, and it's been there for years. I don't know how long it's been there. It's been there. When God spoke of it, it stood still. When He spoke of the seas and the oceans.
Yes, Lordy. Yes, Lordy.
That's sound doctrine.
Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Sound doctrine is God's communication with the world. My God, this is something that church has forgotten.
Yes.
The Word of God is what communicates to us.
Yes, it does.
That's how He communicates with His people.
Will you say that?
I don't want to keep, I keep hearing people always say, well, you know, the Bible has, you know, there's many translations and many interpretations. There's different translations, but there's only one interpretation.
All right.
Make that plain.
All right.
The Bible has been translated so that it can be easily understood.
Yes.
Concerning the audiences.
Yes.
Some people, me, I don't read out of the King James Bible.
Right.
The Thousand Arts is just too much for me.
Uh-huh.
So I went to the next one, New King James.
Yes.
The boys, they can read the NIV.
Yes.
But it's still it's still interpreted the same.
All right now. Yes, yes, yes.
Thou shalt not murder in King James is going to say you shall not kill or murder in the NIV.
All right now.
It's the same interpretation.
Yes. Will you say that and make it plain?
Yes.
You're making it plain, woman of God. Hallelujah.
Sound doctrine is a firm foundation to keep us from turning away.
Thank you, Jesus.
As I said before, God is not speaking anything new. The Bible says in Psalms 119 and 89, forever, O Lord, your word is settled in heaven.
Uh-huh.
The wise King Solomon said it. He said that there is nothing changed under the sun.
Nothing.
There is nothing different. That's why God has made this word for us. He has made it available so that there's nothing in here that will cause us confusion, that will cause us to question.
Well.
Has been written since He created mankind.
That's right. That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
You're wondering, well, how is this a sound? Well, because the word of God must come forth. God is speaking. We just have to hear. Amen?
Yes.
We have to give attention to what the Lord is saying to
us
in His word.
Yes.
King David, he had told his son in Proverbs chapter 4, verses 20 and 22, and you can write down these scriptures. He said, my son, give attention to my words.
Yes.
Incline your ear to my sayings. Do not let them depart from your eyes.
That's
keep
right.
them in the midst of your heart. For they are life to those who find them and health to all their flesh. Amen?
Amen.
So I define sound doctrine as sound doctrine being healthy.
Yes.
God's word is healthy to
it's
our bones.
Healthy.
It's health to our very soul.
Our
he said to give attention to my words. We have to pay attention to what God is saying.
Amen.
That's the sound that we must adhere to.
Yes.
God is communicating through His word. We must listen. Amen.
Amen now.
We must incline our ear to what God is saying. And we must not let them depart from us. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
God's word is like medicine. That's what the sound doctrine is. It's
yes.
Now, if the doctor tells you there's a certain diet plan you need to follow or a certain medication you need to take,
yes.
you have to listen to the instructions
that's right.
he or she is telling you.
Yes.
You have to pay close attention. Amen.
That's it.
It's no different with God's word. God's word is medicine to us.
Yes.
Take two Psalm 3 and call me Lord.
All right now.
Okay.
So let's go to Isaiah chapter 30, and we're going to read verse 21. Isaiah chapter 30, verse 21. Amen. He said, your ear shall hear a word behind you saying, this is the way.
Yeah.
Walk in it.
Mm.
Is not God telling us that through His word?
Yes, He is.
He's speaking to us. He said, you shall hear a word. That
yes.
word comes through the word of God. It may
yes.
come through our pastor.
Yes.
It may come through a prophet. It may come through wherever the case may be, as long as it's the word.
Yes.
He said, you shall hear the word.
Yes.
So there's no excuses. The world has heard the word.
Yes, they have.
There's no excuse.
There's no excuse. None whatsoever.
And it has been explained and has been explained to them, this is the way.
Yeah.
Walk in it.
But hallelujah.
They have chosen to reject the sound. Amen.
That's it.
There is a specific sound. Glory to God.
Jesus.
So let's go back to Titus chapter 1, verse 9. And I really want to explain this because this is what God is calling us. This is word. This is not me. This
yes.
is what God is telling us. He said
yes.
we must hear sound doctrine. We must take heed to it. Amen. So let's go back to Titus chapter 1 and verse 9.
And it says, holding fast the faithful word as he hath been taught, that he may be able by sound doctrine both to exhort and to convince the naysayers.
That's right. So sound doctrine is faithful. Uh-huh. It keeps us from doing what
thank you, Jesus.
It keeps us from being self-willed and self-controlled.
Thank you, Jesus.
And it helps us to be self-controlled. Amen?
Yes.
So, you know, if you, you know, as parents, you know, I have to make sure that my kids are disciplined in a certain way.
Yes.
That they are ordered to listen to me and hear my instructions.
Yes.
Yes.
It's the same way. It's, and they're faithful sayings. I'm never going to say anything to my children that will cause them to stumble or cause them to get off course. It's a faithful saying.
Hallelujah.
You know, it's good. These are good, wholesome words that I speak. It's the same as the
thank you, Jesus.
He said that if we continue to hear him, listen to this sound, that we will be self-controlled. These are faithful words to us. He said he's not a man that shall lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. Yes. Whatever he speaks to us is right, and it will not
will you say us. That? Hallelujah.
That's right.
Thank you,
this
Jesus.
This is why God teaches us not to be tossed to and fro by every wind of doctrine. Let's go to Ephesians 4 and 14. He doesn't want us, we have to adhere to sound doctrine, because if we don't follow after sound doctrine, it's going to be easy for us to get off course, to be wavered in our faith, not believing what the word of God is saying, start questioning or even doubting what even God's saying, because we have not been trained properly into sound doctrine. Amen?
Amen.
Ephesians 4:14.
That we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro, and carried about with every wind of doctrine, by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness, whereby they lie in wait to deceive.
That's right.
Yes.
We prayed about deception, because it's truly in the land. Even
yes, it is.
It
is.
This is why we need sound doctrine, because we have to hear the voice of God.
Yes, Lord.
Matter if we're visiting different churches or if we're going to different church events, we have to adhere to sound doctrine.
Hallelujah.
If we don't know what this word is saying, it's going to be easily, we're going to be easily deceived by what the pastor is saying or what the minister is saying, and it may not even be in line with the word of God.
Yes, come on now.
That's really going on today.
Yes, Lord.
Because it should not be difference of doctrine.
Yes.
We are not following after the book of opinions. This is not the book of opinions.
All right, woman of God.
Okay. I'm seeing pastors preaching. They're preaching based out of the book of opinion.
Yes.
Based on what they feel and what they know.
All right.
My Lord.
This is not what God wants from us. We're living in perilous times, people of God.
Yes.
And the Bible says that people are not going to want to endure sound doctrine.
They don't.
They're starting to reject it. Even pastors and preachers.
Yep.
You know, like I said, I was telling you, I was talking to a lady on the phone, and her husband's a pastor. You know, she says she's a woman of God. And when I began to bring up Jesus' return, I just heard, you know, pin needles dropping.
My Lord.
I didn't hear no amen or response to sound doctrine.
Jesus.
I wasn't speaking anything else. She heard the word, and the word is right.
Yes,
but there was no
true
response to that.
Right.
Jesus. My Lord.
The other day is because they're not believing it, because it's not happening.
Mm-mm.
But there is a sound that we still must adhere to.
Hallelujah.
I don't care if God is still speaking the basis.
Yes,
the
he is.
God. I don't care if we don't see the manifestation of Christ's return just yet, but there are certain sounds in the earth that are happening that is showing evidence.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Is that not enough sound for you?
Come on now. It should be.
But it's obviously it's not, because people are starting to reject it.
Jesus.
Listen and adhere to sound doctrine.
Help us, Father.
The word of God is said. Let's go to 2 Timothy chapter 4, and we're going to read verses 3 through 5.
My God.
2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 3 through 5.
For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lusts shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and shall be turned unto fables.
They're not listening.
Yes.
They have rejected the sound of God. I told you before where I was listening to one of the street preachers preaching, and this church called Hills Farm Church is a big mega church.
Yeah.
And they had asked him why they have so many members. He said, because they have itching ears and we're scratching it for them.
My Lord.
That is a terrible thing. Now, they openly confess that. Now, there's some pastors that they may not have said it, but their actions speak louder than
yes.
Wow.
They may not be
saying have mercy, Lord. Have mercy, Lord.
But they're truly doing it.
Jesus, Jesus.
So this is what the Bible is saying. They're not hearing the sound of God anymore. They stop listening to his voice. They stop listening to what the word of God is saying. They want to hear things now that's going to benefit them.
My Lord.
Or fit their need or whatever the case may be. They have stopped enduring sound doctrine.
Jesus, have mercy, yes. Lord. Have mercy. My Lord.
That's right. He said that hearing you will hear and shall not understand. Yes. So people are hearing the word of God, but because they have been so unstable,
say that.
The word of God, they're not able to understand anymore.
My Lord.
They're becoming ignorant.
Yes.
To the word of God.
Yes.
God, I'm seeing this all
yes.
the time.
Yes.
You know, you act like you done forgot what the word was saying.
Oh, and yes.
You heard everything. You heard it. And you
yes.
believed and you stood on the word, but because you don't see no evidence, well,
yes.
then that's no faith. And we're going to get into that sound faith.
Yes.
Because the Bible says faith is the substance of things hoped for. It's the evidence of things.
Yes, Lordy.
So it doesn't matter what we don't see in our visible eye.
Come on now. Yes, this is
so
spiritual.
They're hearing the word now, but now they're acting ignorant. That's why they never learned nothing before.
Jesus.
Amen. It's just like forgetting what 1 + 1 is. That's how the ignorance is.
My God. Help us, Lord. Help us. Help us. Help us. Help us.
They're losing their understanding of what the word is saying because they're
Jesus.
They're listening to the whispers and the ungodliness, the godly counsels of the enemy.
My Lord.
That's why the prophet Samson, he said, we got to tune out the world.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did.
The world is saying. Because right now, the world is in opposition to Christ.
Oh, yes.
Be real. The world is in so much opposition.
Yes, they are.
Even though God, if he can save Paul, I know he can save them. But I'm just saying, right now, they are really fighting against the bricks right now.
Yes.
They don't want to hear nothing about Christ. That's not
Amen.
What they want to hear.
My
they
God.
Hear other things that's
have mercy, Lord. Good. Have mercy.
Make them feel like, okay,
nope.
You're special.
Nope.
You is beautiful. You
nope.
is smart. You is wonderful. That's what
nope.
they want to hear. They
that's
don't want to hear the abuse.
It ain't working.
The judgment of God that's getting ready to happen in the earth.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hebrews 3:15. It says, today if you will hear his voice,
uh-huh.
do not harden your hearts as in the rebellion. Well, we see a lot of rebellion. This is a rebellious generation that is happening.
Yes.
The 21st century church that's going on today. They have hardened the hearts. They have stopped listening to God's sound. Amen?
Yes.
Let's go to 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 16 and 18. I got a few scriptures about the sound.
That's all right.
2 Peter chapter 3, verses 16 through 18.
Hallelujah.
16 through 18.
Okay. Then it says, whoever hates his brother is a murderer.
Nope, 2 Peter chapter 3.
As also in all his epistles, speaking in them of these things, in which some things hard to be understood, which they that are unlearned and unstable rest, as they do also the other scriptures, unto their own destruction. Ye therefore, beloved, seeing ye know these things before, beware lest ye also, my God, being led away with the error of the wicked, fall from your own steadfastness. Jesus. Oh, but grow in grace
yes.
and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him be glory both now and forever.
Amen. He said, the writer said, people twist to their own destruction. They're
My Lord.
The word of God.
They do.
They do as the rest of the scripture. But he said, you therefore, you know this beforehand. See, people of God, we know that this is what's going to happen.
Yes.
We know that people are not going to listen to the true word of God anymore. We see this growing day by day.
Yes.
That's why he said, grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus.
That's where sound doctrine comes in. We have to grow in this
Help us, Lord. Help us.
Word of God.
Help us.
People are twisting it.
Yes, they are.
A word that's uncorrupted to be corrupted.
Jesus.
There is a word that's true to be a lie.
My God.
We have to be steadfast in everything.
Help us, Father. Help us.
We know what the word of God is saying.
Yes, Lordy.
We are set in it. It's settled in our heart. Like
yes, it is.
Settled in our heart.
Yes.
And even when the enemy tries to bring deception, that's where we have to tune out that voice and allow God to speak to us.
Hallelujah.
We have to know.
Thank you, Jesus. Jesus.
Because God, He begins to speak to us. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, yes.
This is why God tells us in 1 John 4:1, not to believe every spirit, but test spirits, whether they are from God. That's why we have to make sure we are set in sound doctrine so we can hear God's voice. We know that when we see things, the Holy Spirit will speak into us and say, oh, nope, that's not right.
Mm-hmm.
That's not the word of God. That is not what God is saying. See, that's what the Holy Spirit
says. Yes, Lordy.
That we need to tune into, the Spirit of the Lord.
Yes.
The Spirit will tell us exactly what's wrong, what's right, what's good, what's evil, what's false, what's true. He'll be able to help us scope out those false teachers.
Come on now. Yes, He will.
False doctrines.
Yes.
In the world. This is the sound that we must adhere to.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
We're living in a world today of a lot of falsehood. It's deception is truly in the land. And again, I had looked up a word the other day called humanism. And that's basically, it's just based on, everything now is based on human standards. It's not based on what God thinks, how He feels, what the consequences are going to be. This is why we have to defend the sound doctrine. We have to defend it at all costs.
My Lord.
Mother Sanders, she had spoke the other day about, a while back, about the old landmark.
Yes.
Did you know that Mother Scott, she heard the sound.
Yes.
She was listening. She was in tune.
Yes.
God's voice. She knew what God was saying.
Yes, Lordy.
This is why when God heard the sound, when she heard the sound, what did she do? She adhered to the sound.
Yes.
And she obeyed and established this ministry.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's important. Whatever God tells us, we have to listen.
Say that. Say that. Amen. Amen. Amen.
That's why that's going on, right?
Yes.
You out of alignment.
And then when something tragic happens to you,
come on.
When things happen, then you're stuck. Then you want to hear the sound.
No. Come on now.
Now you want God to speak to you. Now you want God to say a word. Well, he's already brought it forth.
Mm-hmm.
He already put it out there.
That's it.
His word is not eternal void, so he's not going to chase. Amen.
Come on now. My Lord. My Lord. Jesus. 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 Jesus.
4, verse 16.
Hallelujah. Take heed unto thyself and unto the doctrine, continue in them, for in doing this thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee.
My God. When I seen the scripture, I said, wow, Lord, this is Mother Scott. Because she adhered to what God was saying.
Yes.
She listened to him. Can you read that one time?
Take heed unto thyself.
Yes.
And unto the doctrine, continue in them, for in doing this thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee.
That's right.
My
so
God.
She took heed to the doctrine.
Yes,
she
did.
Heed to the sound of God.
Yes, she
he
did.
Spoke and she listened. She obeyed.
Hallelujah.
She heeded in them until the day she breathed her last breath on there.
Yes,
and she said, if we do this, it will save both your soul.
Will you say that?
Did it not preserve pastor?
Hallelujah. Yes, it did. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Wonderful Savior.
So we have to continue. We have to take heed to this doctrine, people of God.
Jesus.
We have to continue. Let God talk to you. Let God
speak to you
in what He's saying in His Word.
Yes.
Anything kind of prophet or word is coming forth, it has to always go back in alignment with the Word.
But come on now.
Said it clearly, and that is so true. I don't care what you're saying or prophesying or speaking. If it ain't in line with the Word, then it's
come
not
on now. Not at all.
Make it play.
This is where we have to get into the church. This is why the LGBT community is so strong today.
Yes.
The pastor, he said, I remember he was debating with this other pastor, and he said, well, you know, God is still speaking. And what he was trying to say is God is still speaking, meaning that he's still speaking new things into existence in the earth. Okay. That devil is a liar.
Oh my.
His word is settled forever.
Yes.
He has not changed. Now, Jesus said, he said, I didn't come to demolish the law. He said, I came to fulfill it.
Yes.
He didn't change anything about what the word is saying.
Not at all. Yes. Will you say that? Will you say that?
Yes. From the Old Testament, all Jesus was doing was just preaching what God already had spoke when he created the heavens.
Come on now. Nothing new. Nothing new.
This is where we have to get into place. This is why God has made it really easy for us.
Yes.
Don't worry about it now. When we go to school and you in kindergarten, you learn this, and then you in the next grade, you're going to learn something.
Yes.
And then the next grade, learn. I thank God for me. I do that in Christ Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Lord, give us the power of retention. Holy Ghost retention.
If you read the book from Genesis to Revelation 20 times, there are still revelations that
yes.
Are yes. Just more exposure. He said that he reveals himself from faith to faith.
Yes.
He's not going to show us everything right then and
there. No, he's not.
He's going to give us just in part here.
Yes.
And the more faith, the more you continue, the more you continue to show himself.
Yes. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yes.
Oh, yes, it is. Lord, I thank you for your word.
My God, we have to really speak on this because people have really twisted what faith is.
Oh, yes.
Amen, Kendrick. Kendrick was saying, you know, his friends, people are believing. As long as you believe, then we're okay. We're okay. We can keep on sinning. As long as we know that Jesus died for our sins, then we know. That's not sound faith.
Mm-mm.
Well, the Bible says, should we keep our sinning so that grace may abound?
No.
He says, certainly not. Amen.
That's right.
So, sound faith is healthy, uncorrupted, unwavering, and true profession of Christ in your life. So, faith does not waver. It's a daily process. That's what sound faith is. Faith is being perfected in us every single day.
Yes.
Faith is being shown through our trials, through our testing, through obstacles. But we know that through sound doctrine, we can have sound faith.
Will you say that?
Sound doctrine will continue to help us to hear what God is saying so that we can continue to walk in
faith. Amen now.
Amen. Faith, as I said, faith comes from sound doctrine. Let's read Romans 10 and 17. Romans chapter 10, verse 17.
And it says,
faith comes by the world, from social media. No, it says faith comes by hearing, and hearing of the who? The
word of God.
Sound faith comes from sound doctrine. Amen.
That's hallelujah.
Without doctrine, there is no sound faith.
Yes.
You can't say that you have faith and you don't read the word.
That's it.
And you can't tell me that. Yes. You can't tell me that you have faith and you don't adhere to sound doctrine.
My Lord.
The word of God is where our faith comes from.
Yes.
How are we going to believe in something that we don't study? How are we going to, it's the same as a relationship. I'm not going to come into a relationship with you or union with you if I don't know nothing about you.
That's right.
I got to get to know you first.
That's right. Hallelujah.
There's a lot of politicians and a lot of people that are doing all these marches and stuff.
Yes, Lordy.
They heard something.
Uh-huh.
Caused them to have faith in that what they stand for.
Yes.
So that's where the word of God comes in.
We hallelujah.
The word of God.
Yes.
So that
amen.
We can have sound faith.
Thank you, Lord.
2 Timothy 1 and 13 says, hold fast the pattern of sound words which you have heard from me. In faith.
Uh huh.
Christ Jesus. He said, hold fast. That means we've got to cling to it.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
We've got to clinch it in our hearts.
Yes.
With the pattern of sound words. God's word is sound words.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
We have to do this in faith.
Hallelujah.
Here we have to adhere and cling to it by faith.
Faith.
So, how is sound faith to sound? Well, don't we have to profess our faith? Amen.
Oh, yes.
This is what I was saying. People need to hear what faith is. Yes, faith can be in action, you know, when we're going through, or the Bible says, let your light shine. But sometimes faith can be exercised, sound faith can be exercised when we go into a bank or a company, and they be like, well, how do you do it? And they be like, oh, you know, it's just a bad day. Well, you know what? God bless you. Today is the day that the Lord has made.
I know that's right.
And be glad. That's sound faith.
Hallelujah.
That's the sound that people need to hear. Amen.
Yes.
Yes.
People need to hear.
Hallelujah.
That's where sound faith comes from. See, there is a sound people of God.
Yes, it is.
That God wants us to hear. And we want
to hear. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Sound is by witnessing. That's through sound doctrine by faith. That's yes. the sound.
Yes.
Speaking to God according to the word when we're tempted or going through trials. That's sound faith. Amen.
Yes, because Lord.
Just like Jesus when he was tempted in the wilderness. The enemy tried to tempt him, but he said, it is written.
Yes.
Yes. Hallelujah.
It is written.
Back up. His faith. Amen.
Hallelujah. That's right. Amen.
We want to hear it. And there should be some evidence behind what we said.
Come on now.
We can't be saying, oh, this is dead, Lord has made, and then next breath, oh, man, I'm just really going through it.
The devil is a liar.
That's
right. That's not sound faith.
That's the unwavering. You gotta have unwavering. Yes.
Amen.
Oh, Jesus.
Let's go back to Titus chapter 2. I'm almost done.
Jesus.
Titus chapter 2, verse 7. Let's go back to that scripture.
In all things, showing thyself a pattern of good works, in doctrine, showing uncorruptness, gratitude, and sincerity.
Yes.
Okay, mine has a different translation.
Yes.
Mine says, to be in all things showing yourself to be a pattern of good works and doctrine, showing integrity. Oh, and then go read verse 8. That's what.
Okay. Sound speech that cannot be condemned, that he that is of the contrary part may be ashamed, having no evil thing to say of you.
That's right. So now we go into our sound speech. This is important in this last week of day.
Yes, Lord.
We have to be careful how we choose our words.
Mm-hmm.
Especially when it comes to the word of God, because the Bible says we must rightly divide the word.
Yes, yes.
So to define sound speech is words uttered through the leading of the Holy Spirit, through sound doctrine and sound faith.
Yes.
So it's all a pattern. Without sound speech, we cannot have sound faith. And without sound faith, we cannot have sound doctrine.
All right.
It's a pattern. It's a mess.
Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
So what Mother Sanders had read in Titus 2 and 7 and 8, sound speech cannot be condemned. And this is something that, you know, God continues to show us. I tell Kendrick all the time, you know, when people are coming against you, all you have to say is in the name of Jesus or the blood of Jesus. That's sound doctrine. It's true. And every time he said that, the enemy has fled.
Yes, yes.
He cannot contradict. The devil can't even contradict the word of God. That's why he had to leave Jesus after he finished tempting him. Even though he waited for another opportune time, but he knows he's insatiable.
Oh, yes.
At that time, if we continue, if we stand on sound doctrine and speak it through faith and have sound speech to speak the word,
yes, the
devil
yes.
contradict it. No matter what people try to come against us and
that's
what we say or what we do or whatever, we lay the word on
them. Amen.
They can't contradict that. They can't.
Thank you, Jesus.
Evil to say.
Thank you, Jesus.
All you do is shut it down, and they keep it pushing until the next time.
Hallelujah.
That's right.
So we must rightly express the word of God so that those who are hearing the word, can be received effectively. Now, don't get it twisted. Just because people may come off a little angry at first when you speak from sound doctrine,
yes.
they have not received it.
Amen. Now, beautiful, beautiful.
Our goal is just to plant seeds.
Yes.
It's not for us to wait around and see a reaction.
Come on now. Come on now.
All we're here to do is to plant the seed and let God do the rest and give the increase.
Yes. Hallelujah.
So let's read Colossians 4 and 6. Colossians chapter 4, verse 6.
Says, let your speech be always with grace, seasoned with salt, that ye may know ye ought to answer every man.
That's right. Our words should be seasoned with grace all the time.
Yes.
And I know it's hard, easier said than done at times, but this is God's word, and this is what he's commanding us to do.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible says in Ecclesiastes 10 and 12, the words of a wise man's mouth are gracious.
Yes.
The lips of the fool shall swallow him up. So we don't want to cause harm in good thing. We don't want to be a harm to anyone when we're speaking the word of God. Because all that'll do, that'll bring about our own destruction if we don't choose our words carefully.
Come on now.
Be mindful because God is recording every word that we say, whether it's good words or evil words.
Yes.
But sound speech, again, is a true profession for from sound doctrine and sound faith. If we have the word of God in our hearts, if we have true faith, God will begin to fill our mouths so that we can
speak
correctly to those who need to hear. Amen.
Hallelujah.
1 Peter 3:15 says, sanctify the Lord God in your hearts, and always be ready to give a defense to everyone who asks you a reason for the hope that is in you, with meekness and fear. So that's that gracious part.
Thank you, Father.
Lord God in our hearts.
Will you say that?
We have to be sanctified.
Hallelujah.
And we always have to be ready. That's why I said, Lord, help me to stop being off guard. I've been getting caught off guard so many times.
Yes.
And I'm like, Lord, help me
to always be ready
to give a reason. Because some people are going to come to you like Kendrick. They're always going to come to you to try to challenge your faith. Or they might really want to just, you know, really know what the hope that lies in you.
Right.
But whatever case, whether it's to argue or oppose, we have to be ready to defend.
Yes.
Because either way, if we have sound speech, they won't be able to contradict it. Right.
Jesus.
Right.
Jesus.
You,
hallelujah.
That's the sound that God wants us to hear. He wants the world to hear sound speech. He wants to hear those gracious words coming out of our mouth.
Thank you, Father.
No, we don't have to sound like we're just so intellectual. No, we don't have to do all that.
Come on now.
That's not what God is
saying. No, no. Not at all. Come on, will you?
Yes.
Woman of God, will you teach?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes, yes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Sound speech will help us to be able to bring correction.
Okay.
This is the part that, Lord, help me on this one.
That's all right.
We have to be careful how we are bringing correction to those.
Yes, yes.
Because sometimes, you know, we get in our own flesh and we may say the wrong thing.
That's it.
You know, we may say something that did not really bring, was effective to that person.
Mm-hmm.
And it may cause more harm. We don't want to injure.
That's right.
Like I said, I'm not going to say it may cause an offense because Jesus is the rock of offense.
He's the
If they're offended, then we're on the right track.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
However, there are some words that we might say that we might, again,
say that.
Yes.
And then the flesh kick in, and then we end up hurting them instead of the broken root. Amen.
And
then God got to clean it up.
Jesus. Yes, He will. Yes, He will.
We want to be trained in this word, God.
Yes.
Oh, yes. Train us, Jesus.
We want to be trained to have that sound faith so that people can hear correctly.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hear correctly what thus saith the Lord God. Amen. Whether it's in exhortation or correction.
Yes.
Let's read 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 2 and 3. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 2 and 3. Amen. He said, preach the word. He said, preach the word.
Yep.
This is what we're called to do with all long suffering. We have to do this because no matter what, they're going to not endure the sound doctrine.
Come on now.
Continue to preach the word.
Yes, Lordy.
It doesn't matter if they're rejecting or speaking against God. We still have to preach the word. That's sound doctrine. I mean, sound speech, excuse me. Sound speech will help us to continue to preach the word, to convince, rebuke, be ready in season, out of season. Always be ready to give a reason.
Yes. Hallelujah.
That's where the Holy Spirit comes in. That's where our faith in the Word of God comes in. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
So if we're being taught by sound doctrine, then we can exhort and convict those who are contradicting His Word. Let's go to Luke 21:14-15. Resist. Amen. He said that He'll give us See, we just have to be willing vessels. We have to be willing vessels to speak the word of God.
Yes, Lordy.
As long as we settle the word of God in our hearts,
Hallelujah. We
don't have to worry about meditating or saying, okay, yeah, the next time I see her, I'm going to say this, that, and I'm going to say, no.
Come on now. Teach, teach. Hallelujah.
Just settle the word in your heart. Be ready. That's all God wants us to be ready vessels. So that way, He said He'll give us a mouth of wisdom.
Yes, God.
Thank
you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, help me to have sound speech.
Yes.
Sound speech is peace and assurance, knowing that God's word, no matter where I I am or what happens in what position, that as long as I settle it in my heart, I know that I'll be able to present and effectively communicate His word.
Yes.
That's all I want.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Lord, help me to effectively communicate Your word.
Yes.
And He said, well, just settle in your heart. That's all you got to do. Just yes. know that my yes. word is true. Yes. You believe it. You have faith. And you'll be able to communicate it.
Yes. Thank you, no Jesus.
Problem. Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Let's see. 1 Peter 4:11. Okay. Three more scriptures.
That's all right.
Luke 10:16. Or first, we're going to say 1 Peter 4:11.
And if any man speak, let him speak as the oracles of God. If any man minister, let him do it as of the ability which God giveth, that God in all things may be glorified through Jesus Christ, to whom be praise and dominion forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. He said, if anyone speaks, let him speak as the oracles of God. At this day and age, all our speech should be nothing but God. It should be nothing but sound doctrine. It should be nothing but the word, period.
Yes.
I know Pastor always says that her grandmother, she didn't have, they didn't just always have casual conversations. Yes. They were always talking about God. Yes. Now, I'm not saying we can't just have, you know, nice yes. conversations with one another, exactly. but it's getting to a point to where we have to sharpen each other.
Hallelujah.
As we possibly can. And any opportunity God gives us to exhort each other.
Say that, say that.
To encourage
yes.
each other in the word of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Have that sound speech.
Yes, God.
That way, you know, because there may be a scripture that you read to me that I, oh, yeah, that's right. And then yes. Lord, bring it up that week to be able to effectively communicate to somebody.
Yes, yes. Hallelujah. Amen. I know that's right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
So we have to speak God's word no matter what. Because, and we have to speak it in a way that shows that we reverence God.
Come on now.
That's the thing right there. We have to speak God's word as though we reverence God.
Yes.
You know, when we talk about something good, we just get so emotional.
Yes.
Oh, this place over here is so nice.
Okay.
I mean, and then you just begin to get into it, and then the person that's listening, you're like, man, I want that too.
So many details.
That's how we should be with God.
Come on now, revelate.
So awesome.
Jesus.
He is just so kind and just so
yes.
Hallelujah.
He just makes me just have joy.
Yes.
Whatever I'm going through, He just spoke into my heart.
Yes, Lord.
Everything's going to be good.
Lord.
God can do His serve.
Yes.
To do this for
yes.
How, I mean, that's just how theatrical we should be.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. And He is.
Hallelujah.
He is.
That's where we need to be today.
Glory to God.
Because right now I'm like, you know what? You need to get yourself right with the Lord. Because you know what? You're living in sin, and I'm just so sick of it. Mother said that frustrated, and I am too.
Hallelujah.
At the end of the day, we still have to represent Christ.
Yes.
And show people that He's just that loving God.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Yes,
yes.
Yes.
Yes. Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, there is.
Yes.
God's word cannot be contradicted. The world, the flesh.
Thank you for your word, God.
The word. But God's word is God's voice. And His voice overpowers all opposing voices in the earth.
Yes, God.
I don't care what you say. I don't care what you believe.
Yes.
God's word is the word and it's real.
Yes, it is. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
So we have to endure sound doctrine. We have to be ready to speak the true gospel, even if it brings affliction and opposition.
Yes.
Because sound doctrine is what's going to keep us in these last and evil days.
Yes.
It's what's going to help us. Sound doctrine is not always going to be tolerated. Let's go to Matthew 24:12. And then someone get ready to read Jeremiah 50:22. And this is one of my last scriptures.
Matthew 24:12 mm-hmm. says, and because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold.
Oh, doesn't it? Isn't that what we see today?
Yes, Lord.
Sin is increasing by the day. And the more sin increases, the more people's hearts are growing dull.
Jesus.
They are not willing to hear. The voice of God is becoming dull to their ears.
Yes, it is.
So we have to continue to keep that spiritual ear tuned.
Yes.
Just like we have to keep a guitar or violin tuned so it sounds right and sounds right.
Yes, Lord.
Spiritual ear tuned to God's voice.
Help us, Lord. Stay in tune with you.
The world is really growing hard and having a hard heart against truth.
Yes.
Against judgment, against this revelation. And it's time for us to start speaking revelation. We have to speak it. That's the sound. Because it's already happening. I mean, even if we don't speak it, God's going to get the glory.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Whether we desire to speak it or not. But we have to be trained in that area. And
hallelujah.
Jeremiah chapter 50, verse 22. Jeremiah chapter 50.
A sound of battle is in the land and of great destruction.
So I leave you with this. We have to listen to the sound because there's sound of war going on right now.
Yes.
There's sound of judgment already in the land, as Mother just said. Sound of battle is in the earth. This is what's happening. This is what's taking place. We're in the sound of government. They're changing laws. There's going to be a sound where
we may lose our
rights to speak.
Yes.
We might not be able to voice our speech or voice the word of God.
Yes.
We're hearing the sound of LGBT.
Jesus.
Corruption. We're hearing sounds of corruption in the church.
Yes.
The pastors are not preaching based off the word of God. They're hearing, they're scratching those itches.
My Lord.
Yes.
My Lord.
So we have to listen to the sound because there's coming a time, and as I present myself, constitutions are going to change. I believe that. New world order.
My Lord.
We're hearing different things of views and changes, you know, and Lord bless, I know we're going to be out of here, but look what's going to happen after God catches us up in the sky.
Yes.
We're going to have to take this 666 number in order for them to eat.
Jesus.
To buy and to sell or even run and operate businesses.
Yes.
These things are getting ready to happen. But
yes.
We have to adhere. We have to get in tune with God's sound. Amen.
Yes, God.
What? Battle cries are in the land, and we believers are the remnant. Summons to stand on this sound, to draw the lost to Jesus Christ. But we have to listen. If we're not listening to sound doctrine, we do not have sound faith and sound speech based on sound doctrine, then we are setting ourselves up for failure. You know, God's going to silence the people.